Blackstone Audio presents Mr. Splitfoot by Samantha Hunt. This book is read by Cassandra Campbell and Emily Wu Zeller. Once again, there are more dead things than ever before. Martha Zweig. 1. We are approaching the greatest of mysteries. We float like a mote of dust in the morning sky. We know that this is impossible. 2. We the people, we believe all the words which thou hast spoken. We cannot understand the words. We fled all that day into the wilderness, even until it was dark. We commanded the rocks and the mountains to fall upon us to hide us. We will rock you. 3. We crossed this great water in darkness. We lost a great number of our choice men. We will change them into cedars. We see there was no chance they should live forever. We will change them into cedars. 4. We have spoken, which is the end. We should call the name. We should call the name. We know that this is impossible. Far from here, there's a church. Inside the church, there's a box. Inside the box is Judas' hand. Nat is slight and striking as a birch branch. Who cut it off? Ruth asks. How? But Nat's a preacher in a fever. His lesson continues with a new topic. Baby deer have no scent when they are born. Nat conducts the air. Keeps those babies safe as long as their stinking mothers stay far away. This is how Nat loves Ruth. He fills her head with his wisdom. My mom doesn't stink.
You don't even know who your mom is, Rue.
Of course I do. She's a veterinarian. She already had too many animals when I was born.
I don't believe you.
Ruth looks left, then right. Okay, she's a bank robber. When you're asleep, she brings me money.
Where's all the cash, then? Are you hiding it in some big cardboard box?
So Ruth swerves again, returning to the version of a mother she uses most often. I mean, my mom's a bird. A red cardinal.
A male? Your mom's a boy.
Yeah.
No, she isn't. She's a stone. Bones. I spit on her.
Nat steals confidence from thin air. Ruth pulls her long dress tight across bent knees. She doesn't even know enough about mothers to fabricate a good one. Her idea of a mother is like a non-dead person's idea of heaven. It must be great. It must be huge. It must be better than what she's got now. I'm just saying, wherever she is, she doesn't stink. Nat flips the feathers of his hair.
Wherever she is.
Exactly. He holds his hand in a ray of sunlight.
I'm here now.
He lifts the hand that touched light up to her ear, squeezing the lobe, an odd, familiar affection between their bodies. Nat touches the scar on her face, tangled knots of tissue, keloids dots on her nose and cheeks.
Do you know how they deliver mail to the bottom of the Grand Canyon?
No.
I taught you this before. Please.
Nat is cruel or Nat is gentle. Nat hates, loves Ruth as much as he hates, loves himself. He'll say,
sleep on the floor tonight.
Or,
I'm taking your blue coat. I like it.
Or,
stop crying right now.
But he'll also say,
eat this. And, you can dance, girl.
And,
stay the fuck away from Ruth or I'll slice your ear cartilage off and give it to a dog to chew on.
When the father raises a switch, Nat gives his back.
Are you just someone who wants to stay stupid?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.